Hello friends, welcome back to ProHut IT Services. Good to see you back. In the last video, we learned the steps of installing DHCP Server on Windows Server 2012 R2. In this video, we learned the steps of configuring DHCP Server on Windows Server 2012 R2. As we are done with the installation of DHCP Server, now let's create a scope. For that, click on Start. Select DHCP to create a scope. Expand IP version 4 option. Right click on IPv4 and click on New Scope. It will start New Scope Wizard. Click on Next. Specify a scope name and description. Description is an optional component. We can specify server name as scope name and then click on Next. On the IP address range window, specify the range of IPs that you want DHCP to assign. For this video, we are configuring scope for 10 IPs, that is 192.168.1.200 to 192.168.1.210. As we have specified IPs from class C, therefore it has taken default subnet mask, that is 255.255.255.0. Click on Next. On the Add Exclusions and Delay window, specify the range of IPs that you want to exclude. DHCP Server will not assign the IPs that you specify in exclusion window. Click on Next. DHCP assigns an IP address for 8 days. 8 days is a default lease duration. It can be increased to 999 days, 23 hours, and 59 minutes. It can also set to unlimited. We'll talk about that later. DHCP Server also gives other information to clients. Example, DNS server information, WINS information, default router information, etc. besides IP address. Select Yes. I want to configure these options now and then click on Next. On the router, that is default gateway window, type an IP address of the router that you want to pass on to all the clients. On the domain name and DNS server window, type IP address of DNS server and click on Add. In this practical, IP of DNS is auto-populated. You can add IPs of all the DNS servers. Once you are done, click on Next. On the WINS server, type IP address of WINS server and click on Next. As we are not using WINS server, therefore we did not add any IP address. Now click on Next. On the Activate Scope window, select Yes if you want your clients to obtain IPs. Clients will not receive or obtain IPs if the scope is not activated. Now click on Next. Now we are done with the configuration, so click on Finish. As you can see, that scope is created. Now let's go back to client and check if clients are receiving IPs from DHCP server or not. We are on client computer now. Let's open command prompt and check IP address by typing ipconfig, that is ipconfig. It will show IP address assigned to your computer. Type ipconfig/all to verify if IP is obtained from DHCP server or not. On the screen, we can see that IP address obtained is 192.168.1.200. This is the first available IP from the range 192.168.1.200 to 192.168.1.210 that DHCP has assigned. I hope you can recall that, right? We assign that as a scope. DHCP enabled is showing as yes, which confirms that IP address is obtained from DHCP server. IP address of DHCP server is 192.168.1.41. IP address of DNS server is 192.168.1.40 as we defined. Lease obtained is for 8 days, that is from November 2nd to November 10th. If you can recall, we have assigned lease for 8 days. Now let's go back to DHCP server and verify if we can find same information on DHCP server or not. Now click on address lease. It shows the IP address 192.168.1.200 is assigned to win8-01, which is our client machine. With this, we are done with the installation and configuration of DHCP on Windows Server 2012 R2. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching this video. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. See you again. Till then, bye, keep smiling, and have fun.